Hello friends, now in this lecture we'll continue with the examples. So here is the next example that we have to solve. That is example number 17, page 553. So next question that I'm going to take from page 553. The medians B and CF, the medians BE and CF of a triangle ABC, of a triangle ABC intersect at G. Intersect at G. Prove that area. Area triangle GBC is equal to area quadrilateral AFGE. Okay, diagram is given. So this is the diagram. Medians are meeting at point G. Triangle is ABC. Okay, this is triangle ABC. Okay, this is BE and this is CF and this point is G. So we have to prove that area of triangle GBC, this is equal to area of quadrilateral AFGE. So let us see its solution. Okay, so first of all, what we have given, okay, we have given, okay, before that let me write, this is from page 553, example number 17. Okay, given in triangle ABC, BE and CF are medians. Okay, to prove area triangle BGC is equal to area quadrilateral AFGE. Okay, so let us see how to prove this. Okay, so let us see its proof. See, BE is a median and we know that median divides a triangle into two triangles of equal area. So BE is a median and median divides the triangle into two triangles of equal area. Therefore, I can write area triangle BEA. Therefore, area triangle BEA is equal to area triangle BEC. Okay, this BEA upper triangle and this lower triangle have equal area because it's a median. Now further, see this BEA, I can write this BEA in these two parts. This quadrilateral plus this triangle. So here I can write area quadrilateral AFGE plus area triangle FGB, area triangle FGB is equal to area triangle BEC. Let it be equation number 1. Okay, simply what I did at the place of BEA, I wrote it this quadrilateral plus this triangle. Now similarly we can write the same result for as CF is a median. Now CF is a median and median divides the triangle into two triangles of equal area. Okay, again I am applying the same concept, that is median of a triangle divides into two triangles. So here I can write area triangle AFC. Therefore area triangle AFC is equal to area triangle BCF. Now again this AFC can be written as this quadrilateral plus this triangle CGE. Therefore area quadrilateral AFGE is equal to plus area triangle GEC, area triangle GEC is equal to area triangle BCF. Let it be equation number 2. Now I will add these two equations. Okay, so now adding first and second we get. So let me write the equations. So area quadrilateral AFGE plus area triangle FGB plus area quadrilateral AFGE plus area triangle. Okay, AFGE GF FGB, then again AFGE plus GEC. So first I took left hand side, GEC is equal to area triangle BEC is equal to area triangle BEC plus area triangle BEC and over here BCF. Okay, so now here you can see we have this AFGE two times. Okay, and these two I will take on that side. So here I'm writing, therefore twice area quadrilateral AFGE is equal to. Now see, I will take this area on that side as well as this area. This is FGB GEC. Okay, so here you can see from BEC if I subtract, see here I have BEC, and from this if I subtract this FGC, AFC is plus area GEC. Okay, so GEC. So here first I write area triangle BEC from this BEC I will subtract this GEC. Okay, so BEC on the right hand side, and this I will write over here minus area triangle GEC plus, I do write area triangle BCF minus area triangle FGB minus area triangle FGB. Okay, simply by adding equation, I took this two times and this and this I am taking on that side with minus sign. So with BEC I took this GEC, and with this BCF I took this FGB. So note it down up to this point. This is almost our answer. Here you can see difference of these. That means if I subtract GEC from BEC, if I subtract this GEC from this BEC, what I will get? BGC. Similarly, if I subtract FGB, that means this portion, from this BCF, again I will get BGC. So here on the right hand side I am going to get twice BGC, and 2 I will cancel out, so I will get my required result. So note it down up to this point, then I will give you the remaining portion of the solution. Okay, so now let us see the remaining portion of the solution. Okay, so here on the right hand side I have twice area quadrilateral AFGE, okay, is equal to, now this, it is BEC minus GEC. BEC minus GEC gives you BGC, area triangle BGC plus, now again BCF minus FGB, BCF minus FGB again gives you BGC, area triangle BGC. So therefore here I can write twice area quadrilateral AFGE is equal to twice area triangle BGC. 2 and 2 I can cancel out from both sides, so I will left with area quadrilateral AFGE is equal to area triangle BGC, hence proof. Okay, so note it down this remaining solution, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now we'll see the next question. That is question number 18th from page number 554. Okay, next we'll see this question. Okay, so let us see the next question. In the given figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. Question is, in the given figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Points P and Q on points P and Q on BC trisects BC in three equal parts. Okay, trisects means equal part in three part. Trisects BC in three equal parts. Prove that. So we have to prove that area triangle APQ is equal to area triangle DPQ is equal to 1/6 of area parallelogram ABCD. Okay, that we have to prove. So let us see the diagram. Okay, this is the diagram. It is given ABCD is a parallelogram. First of all, ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. ABCD is a parallelogram P and Q. So P and Q are points on BC such that they are equal. That means say CQ equal to QP equal to PB. These three parts are equal, and we have to prove that area triangle APQ. So let me draw the triangle APQ. First of all, this is the triangle APQ. Then area triangle DPQ. Okay, these two I can say directly equal because they are on the same base and between same parallels. Okay, so these two first two are I can say directly equal without or just by applying a theorem. These two triangles have the common base PQ and lying between same parallels BC and AD. So these two are directly equal. Now area of, we have to prove this is area, this is, these two are equal to the 1/6 of the area of ABCD. So let us see how to solve this. So first of all, we have given ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, P comma Q or P and Q lie on BC such that CQ is equal to QP is equal to PB is equal to, I can say, 1/3 of BC. Okay. To prove, you can directly write as to prove given in the question itself. Okay, so to prove this, I have to prove. So now a small construction is required. Okay. Okay, very small construction is required. Construction draw draw AZ perpendicular BC. Draw AZ perpendicular BC. Let AZ is equal to H. Okay, now we will see its proof. It's very easy. Even though I can prove it by just by applying the formula of area of parallelogram, that is also a way to get this solution or to prove this. Okay, so first I do write triangle APQ, triangle APQ and triangle DPQ are on the same base, are on the same base PQ, are on the same base PQ, and between same parallels, and between same parallels BC and AD. Therefore, I can say area triangle APQ is equal to area triangle DPQ. Also, I can say this is equal to 1 upon 2 base, that is PQ, into height, that is H. Okay, let it be equation number 1. Now area parallelogram ABCD is equal to 1 upon 2, only base into height, PQ into H. Now, area parallelogram ABCD is equal to base, that is BC, and height, that is H. So, here, therefore, area parallelogram ABCD can be written as, now instead of BC I can write 3. Okay, we have to prove here it should be 1/2, because here we are talking about the area of triangle. Here it is not required 1/2, 1/2 into PQ into H. Now instead of BC, or a better way to prove this, here, therefore I can write, therefore area APQ is equal to area triangle DPQ is equal to 1/2. Now instead of PQ I can write 1/3 BC, or BC by 3 multiplied by H. Therefore area triangle APQ is equal to area triangle DPQ is equal to 1/6 into BC into H. Now BC into H, that is base into height, so BC into H is the area of parallelogram ABCD. So here I got my final answer, APQ is equal to area triangle DPQ is equal to 1/6, and instead of BC into H I can write area parallelogram ABCD. Hence proof. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, so after this we'll see the next question. So this is the next question. Okay, in this question it is given that in the given figure, line L, M and N are straight lines such that L and M are parallel. This line L and N intersect. This line N intersects the line L at P and M at Q. Okay. Now ABCD is a quadrilateral. It is given ABCD is a quadrilateral such that its vertex A is on line L, the vertices C and D are on line M. Also it is given this AD is parallel to N. So we have to prove that area of ABCQ, this ABCQ, this ABCQ, this quadrilateral ABCQ we can say, is equal to area of ABCDP, ABCDP. Okay, this, these two we have to prove are equal in area. So we'll start with given. Okay, given in the figure. In the figure, L parallel M. Okay, in the given it is given line L is parallel to M. Also it is given AD parallel N, AD parallel N, A belongs to line L, C and D belongs to line M. Okay, ABCD is a quadrilateral. To prove, okay, we have to prove area ABCQ, area ABCQ is equal to area ABCDP, ABCDP, that we have to prove. So let us see how to prove this. It's not that much difficult, just you have to take a keen observation. See, we need to prove this ABCQ, ABCQ. ABCQ and we have to prove ABCDP. Now these two figures, this ABCQ and ABCDP, have this portion common. If you observe carefully, this quadrilateral ABCD is a common among the ABCQ as well as ABCDP. Now one thing more which we'll get, that if I add this ABCD in triangle ADQ, I will get ABCQ, and if I add this ABCD in triangle ADP, then I will get this. That means, anyhow, now my requirement is to prove triangle ADP is equal to triangle ADQ, which is but obvious because they are on the same base AD and between same parallels AD and N. So first, I prove these two triangles have equal area, and then by adding the common portion in these two areas, I will get my required result. So here triangle ADQ and triangle ADP and triangle ADP are on the same base, are on the same base, are on the same base AD and between, and between same parallels, and between same parallels AD and N, and between same parallels AD parallel, therefore a triangle ADP, area triangle ADQ therefore area triangle ADQ is equal to area triangle ADP. Okay, ADQ is equal to ADP. Now I will add ABCD. Now area triangle ADQ plus area quadrilateral ABCD. I added ABCD on both side. Area ABCD. Okay, so in triangle ADQ I added ABCD, so this gives you ABCQ. Similarly, if I add this ABCD in triangle ADP, I will get ABCP. So here I am getting my final answer. Therefore, I can write area ABCQ is equal to area ABCDP. Hence proof. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, this question actually I took from page 554. Let me write that. Page 554, example number 19. Okay, now we'll see next question, example number 21, page 555. Page 555, example number 21. Okay, so question is XY is a line. XY is a line parallel to side BC of triangle ABC. Of triangle ABC, if BE parallel EC, if BE parallel AC, and CF parallel AB, and CF parallel AB, CF parallel AB meet XY at E and F. Respectively, show that or prove that area ABE ACF, area ABE is equal to area ACF. Okay, here again you can see diagram is not given in the question. So XY is a line parallel to side BC of triangle ABC. So first of all we have to draw triangle ABC. Okay, let this is the triangle ABC. Okay, according to question you have to draw the diagram. XY is a line parallel to side BC of triangle ABC. Okay, XY is a line. Okay, so that XY might be this or might be in this way, but further it is given BE parallel AC. Suppose I draw XY in this way for a while. If I draw a line XY in this way, which is parallel to BC. Okay, XY is a line parallel to BC. Now further it is given if BE parallel AC, that means BE parallel AC I can draw in this way only. Okay, BE parallel AC. This is the line XY. Let this is the point X and let and this is here only, here where anywhere we have point Y. BE parallel AC, then CF parallel AB, CF parallel AB in this way, CF parallel AB. Okay, so we have to prove area triangle ABE, that means this. If I join this, then only I will get area triangle AB as well as area triangle ACF. This we have to prove. So let us see how to prove, but first let me write what is given in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, XY parallel BC, XY parallel BC. Okay, also we have also BE parallel AC and BE parallel AC and AB parallel CF, AB parallel CF. To prove area triangle ABE is equal to area triangle ACF. Okay, so that is actually not the construction part because it is given in the question itself, name of this triangle. So this is the triangle that we have to prove are equal in area. So how to solve this? See, these two are parallel. Okay, these two are parallel and this XY is also parallel to BC. So first of all I can say this EBC, let this point is Z for a while. So this EBCZ, okay, this is a parallelogram. Okay, can I say this is a parallelogram? Definitely this is a parallelogram because it is given BC parallel EZ as BC parallel XY. So I can say BC parallel EZ. So these two sides are parallel to each other. Also it is given BE parallel CA, so BE parallel CZ, so it's a parallelogram. Now I can say this triangle BEA and this parallelogram EBCZ are on the same base BE and between same parallel BE and AC. Okay, so area of this triangle will be half of the area of this parallelogram. Similarly, area of this triangle ACF will be half of the area of this parallelogram. Okay. Now, these two parallelograms are again equal in area. So, by these three equations, I can say area of this triangle is equal to area of this triangle. So, now we'll see its proof in steps. Okay, let us start its proof. So first of all, it is required to prove these two are parallelogram BCZE as well as BCF. If I say this point, that this point is Z and this point is Q, so I have to prove BCFZ and BCQE are parallelogram. So quadrilateral BCFZ, in quadrilateral BCFZ, in quadrilateral BCFZ, BC parallel ZF, BC parallel ZF. Okay, reason BC, why BC parallel ZF? As BC parallel XY, as BC parallel XY given, and CF parallel ZF. Okay, I took these two are parallel. Why these two are parallel? Because it is given BC parallel XY. Now I'll take CF parallel BZ and CF parallel BZ. Now why CF parallel BZ? Because CF parallel AB given, as CF parallel AB given. Therefore, I'll conclude, therefore BCFZ, therefore quadrilateral BCFZ is a parallelogram. Okay, so I proved this is a parallelogram. Now similarly, I proved BCQE is a parallelogram. Now in quadrilateral BCQE, BCQE, BC parallel BC parallel QE, BC parallel QE. Why BC parallel QE? Because BC parallel XY, as BC parallel XY given, and CQ parallel BE, and CQ parallel BE, as CQ parallel, sorry, as CA parallel, CA parallel BE, again given. Okay, it is given CA parallel, CXY parallel BC is given, BE parallel BC is given, and AB parallel CFR, CA parallel BE, this CA parallel BE. So therefore I can say quadrilateral BCQE is a parallelogram. Okay, so first I proved these two are parallelogram. As they are parallelograms, as well as they have common base BC, also they lie between same parallel, so they must be equal in area. Now parallelogram, now parallelogram BCFZ, BCFZ, and parallelogram BCQE, BCQE lie on same base BC, and between same parallels, and between same parallels, that is BC parallel XY. Therefore area parallelogram BCFZ is equal to area parallelogram BCQE. Okay, so here these two parallelograms are equal in area. Now what I will prove, I prove this EBA or ABE is equal to half of this BCQE. Similarly, I will prove this ACF is equal to half of this parallelogram. That means that this triangle is half of this parallelogram, and another triangle is half of this parallelogram, and these two parallelograms are equal, so we can conclude the area of triangles will be equal. So now triangle ABE and parallelogram BCQE, and parallelogram BCQE are on same base BE and between same parallels, which two parallels? BE and AC. Between same parallels, BE and AC. Okay, they are on the same base. Okay, this triangle and this parallelogram are on the same base, as well as they are on the between same parallels. How to identify they are between same parallels? Remaining vertex of triangle is A. Remaining vertices of parallelogram are Q and C, are on the same line which is parallel to the base. Therefore, I can write, therefore, area triangle ABE is equal to half area parallelogram BCQE. Let it be second. Okay, now similarly, I will find one more result, that area triangle CFA or ACF and area parallelogram BCFZ are on the same base CF, between same parallel CF and AB. So again, area of this triangle will be half of area of parallelogram. And all we already proved that those two parallelogram are equal in area. So we can conclude that area of those two triangle will also be equal. So note it down up to this point, then I will give you the remaining solution. Okay, now let us see how to solve it further. So I need this equation 1 as well as equation 2. These two I need. Okay, so now triangle ACF and parallelogram BCFZ are on the same base CF and between same parallels and between same parallels CF and CF between same parallels CF and AB so definitely area of triangle will be half the area of parallelogram. okay, so I can write therefore area triangle ACF, area triangle ACF is equal to 1 by 2 area parallelogram A parallelogram area parallelogram BCFZ BCFZ, let it be third. Okay, now first says that these two parallelograms are equal in area, so their half will be equal. Okay, and second says that AB is equal to half of BCQE. Third says ACF is equal to half of BCFZ. So from first, second and third I can conclude. Okay, so now from first, second and third I can say area triangle ACF is equal to area triangle ABE. From first, second and third I can conclude area triangle ACF is equal to area triangle area triangle ABE is equal to area triangle ACF, hence proof. So please note it down, then I will give you its solution in short once again. I will explain this you once again, but first of all note it down. Okay, so I hope you got this concept. In short, I am explaining you once again. See, first I took these two parallelograms are equal in area. Okay, these two are in equal in area. That I proved by saying that they are on the same base and between same parallels. But before that, I need to prove they are parallelograms. So very first thing, I proved this BCZ and BC. QE are parallelograms. Once I proved they are parallelogram, I use the concept that two parallelograms which lie on the same base and between same parallels are equal in area. So in short, I am saying parallelogram 1 is equal to parallelogram 2. Okay, actually I did this. Okay, then I took this triangle, that is ABE, and this parallelogram 1 I can say. Now this triangle and this parallelogram are on the same base and between same parallels. So I can say area of triangle, okay, here when I say parallelogram 1 equal to 2, I can say 1 by 2 of parallelogram 1 is equal to 1 by 2 of parallelogram 2. Okay, that means if two parallelograms are equal in area, their half will be equal. Then I took this triangle is equal to half of parallelogram. Triangle 1 is equal to 1 by 2 of parallelogram 1 because they are on the same base EB and between same parallels EB and AC. Similarly, I took this CF ACF and this second parallelogram. That means triangle 2, okay, triangle 2 is equal to half of parallelogram 2 in this way, because again they are on the same base and between same parallel. So now here triangle 1 is equal to half of parallelogram 1, triangle 2 is equal to half of parallelogram 2, and these two are, I proved, already equal. So but obviously these two triangles will be equal in area. So I hope you got this concept. So that is all about this lecture. Now we'll meet in next lecture. Till then, bye. Thank you. Take care. Stay at home.